Hello everyone, welcome to Zhong's Real World Data. This is Zhong Wang. In this video, I will use real world data to show you how to remove invalid data in R. I will introduce four scenarios, including non-data rows, testing data, incomplete responses, and uncommon responses. Now I open a lecture note for today's video. Let's first import the data into R. If you are not sure how to import your data, please check my previous video. Okay, I set the working directory and then import the CSV file. And I call the data mydata.csv. The first scenario is about non-data rows. In my example, I will need to remove the first two rows from the data, as they are variable names and labels rather than data. Before I delete the two rows, let's check the dimension of the data. mydata.csv. Okay, now mydata.csv includes 69 rows. Let me open the PDF file and copy the codes for removing non-data rows. Okay, by running this code, the first two rows will be removed from the data, and the new data is named mydata.csv1. Here, the information before the comma is used to specify the rows, and after the comma is used to describe the columns. Here, the minus sign means removing. C12 means we want to remove more than one row. And in this case, we want to remove row 1 and row 2. Let's run it. So here, I'm checking the dimension of the new data. And now it includes 67 rows. The second scenario is about testing data. Usually, researchers will test their surveys or experiments before data collection. And in this case, I have previewed and tested the online survey several times before I started my formal data collection on March 20th, 2019. Let's open the lecture note and copy the R codes and the removing testing data. And paste. To remove the testing data, here I use a subset function to select the cases with start date after March 20th. 2019, 8 a.m. from mydata.csv1. Let's run it and check the dimension of the new data. And this mydata.csv2 includes 51 rows. The third scenario is about incomplete responses. Two variables in this data can serve as indicators of incomplete responses, which are progress and finished. Since the variable progress includes a bit more information, here I removed incomplete data based on progress. Here I copied the code from the PDF file. Like before I remove incomplete data, first I would like to have an overview of this variable progress based on the contingent table. I can see that among the 51 observations, 50 of them have progress value of 100, and one of them has a progress value of 4. To get rid of this incomplete case, I use a subset function to select cases with progress value of 100. Please notice that here you need to use double equal signs. And also progress is saved as a string variable. Here, when I compare this variable with 100, I need to convert it into numeric. Let's run the code and check the dimension of the new data, mydata.csv3. And as we expected, the new data includes 50 rows. The fourth scenario is about uncommon responses. These data were collected from an in-person learning experiment. The estimated time to complete the experiment is 30 minutes. Therefore, I decide to remove the cases with completion time less than 15 minutes or more than 60 minutes. And the variable duration in seconds is used for data selection. And these codes are copied from the PDF file. Similarly, I use the subset function to select cases with response time greater than 900 seconds and less than 3,600 seconds. And similarly, because duration in seconds is stored as a string variable here, I also convert the variable to numeric. Let's run the code. Check the dimension of the new data. And the new data includes 46 rows now. Now I have removed all invalid data based on the four scenarios I talked about. Let's open the PDF again and check the last codes. And I saved the valid data as our R file called mydata.valid for future use. And to save the R file, we need to use this function save_rds. In the next video, I will show you how to rename your variables in R. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.